Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. If you are new here, we are a minimalist family who are living big with less, and today we are talking about all things simplifying routines. So I, as I'm sure you are, have a very busy family life, and we've got lots going on between school and church and all the fun things that life brings. But I'm going to tell you a little bit about how I simplified and de-stressed some of our schedules so that we get more done a lot calmer. So if you're interested, stick around. So guys, as I said, we are all so busy. We are a blended family, so our days look really different. Some days I have five kids, some days I have three, some days I do one school drop-off, and sometimes I do three school drop-offs. But I have found some things that have really helped to streamline our routines and make things run a little smoother. So I thought I would share some of the tips that I found really helpful. Please, please, please take what you like and leave what you don't, because everybody's lives and needs are so different that whatever you're doing, if it's working for you, you do it. That is the best way. So guys, my first tip for you is let go of routines or schedules that are not working for you. So there are some great resources out there. There is Fly Lady and Marie Kondo and all sorts of things out there to get organized and cleaning routines, but not all those things work for everybody. And one of the things that I found really freeing was when I let go of those routines, that we were actually able to find routines that worked way better for us. So for example, I actually don't have a cleaning routine. I just do what is urgent first and then leave the rest. Whatever I get done, I get done, because when I tried doing Fly Lady and other cleaning methods, what would end up happening is my kids would drop, you know, 2 liters of juice over the kitchen floor, and then I would end up washing my floors on Monday instead of Wednesday when I was supposed to. And I would end up feeling like this big failure because I hadn't got all the things done on the list. But I've now found some things that are really working for me. And so just letting go of those routines that are not working for you. Don't try and fit a round peg into a square hole. You do you, and everyone, the end result is far more important than how it took you to get there. My second tip for you is to don't be scared to do something out of the box. So for example, I obviously do YouTube things. We've got emails and editing and comments to reply to, which I absolutely love. Please leave me a comment down below. But I was constantly finding that I wasn't finding this time to work. And so what I found really helpful was just moving my laptop out to the kitchen bench where I could be with kids, be watching dinner or watching kids, and I don't have to worry about, you know, set aside this special time for work, that I can do it on the go. And I actually was approached by a lovely company called Moft. They offered to send me a laptop stand, which I was like, yeah, I can't wait to try it. This is not sponsored. They just sent it to me. And I absolutely love it. It makes working out in my kitchen so much easier. If you're interested, I'll leave a link down below which will give you $2 off. Some other things that I have tried that are a bit weird is that I used to try and do my quiet time or sit down and have a coffee in the mornings, and that would just, it would never work. It was like a train. I would stop my momentum. So now I actually have this little routine where I get up and I make my coffee in the morning, but from then on till when I drop the kids at school, I actually don't sit down. I just keep that train moving. I'm there for my kids. I don't use my phone during that time. That's all devoted to helping them get out of the house. It makes our mornings run so much smoother. I can't even tell you. The fact that I'm up and moving helps the kids to get up and moving. It has been an absolute life changer for me. And I definitely make time to sit down later in the day, but in that short space of time between when we get up and when we need to start doing the school run, I just stand up, I'm getting lunches, I'm getting breakfast, and I'm keeping everybody moving. And it has made our morning so much calmer because my kids don't feel like they're interrupting me, which they should never feel like. You know, they're not interrupting my time or anything like that. We're just working together to get out of the house. My next tip for you is about building rest into your day. So whether you have some physical health issues or mental health issues, or you just are a tired mum, which happens because you're not getting any sleep because your baby's up five times a night, is build rest into your day. So for example, when I'm putting Hamish down for a nap, I lie down next to him. Sometimes I have a nap, sometimes I don't. I just enjoy the peace and quiet of a moment to allow my body to rest. I often have health issues, and so sometimes my body desperately needs the rest. And I find I am a much better wife, mother, and friend if I've had that little rest. And I'd much rather give 20 minutes of rest time and then feel really good in the afternoon than push through and then feel really yucky once 3 o'clock hits. On this same topic about building rest into your day, I also think it's important to plan fun and family time the same way you would plan work or have to do things. So we try and build in like time after dinner to read with our kids or play games, and we plan it exactly like we would plan it if we were working. So it's as important to us, because let me tell you, if you don't plan that stuff, if you don't plan family time or date nights or whatever it is, life will catch up with you and you will not get to it. So do yourself a play favor, plan in some rest or some fun time, some downtime to relax, and I guarantee you, you'll be way more productive. This tip, if you've been around for any length of time, you've probably heard me say it before, and that is clean little and clean often. So like I said, I don't have any sort of cleaning routine. I just write a really detailed list every day of what I'd like to get done in the day, and I use a little highlighter to highlight the things that are most important to do. So for example, if I know that the floors desperately need doing, or the windows, or so-and-so's sheets desperately need changing, those are the things I'll put up first to make sure they definitely get done. And then I'll just plan out the rest underneath. It's a bit like that age-old example of like putting the big stones in first and then pouring the sand in over the top, exactly like that. I just do it with cleaning. So the most important things to get clean, I put at the top, and then I fill it in with whatever else I can get to on that day. And that is how we keep it super simple and everything just gets done. Obviously, I personally find that minimalism has helped with our overall cleaning time. We live in a much smaller home now, so it's a lot quicker to clean, and with less things, I spend less time cleaning. But little and often, picking up the kids' toys before it becomes a huge mess, putting little things away that have appeared on the bench before we can't use the bench or those sorts of things, it's so much easier to find 5 minutes than it is to find half an hour. My last tip for you is be intentional with your time like you would be with your money. So for us, we are really busy, but I know that I am really susceptible to going into a social media black hole. So I can spend way too long scrolling or going down a YouTube path that, you know, hours have gone by and I've got nothing done. So I try and be really intentional with my social media use. I really, really like the time restrictions I put on my phone. So it's just a gentle reminder to me, oh, hey, I give myself half an hour of social media time a day. And once that time is up, unless it's something necessary for YouTube or something like that, I will give myself an extra 15 minutes if I need it. But then it's those gentle reminders that, hey, I don't want to be on here for too long. And I would find that I'm kind of embarrassed to admit this, but I can easily let it get out of control, and I would become snappy with my kids for interrupting me when really I should have been giving my family and my husband my attention. but I was too involved in what was on my screen. So just these little checks and balances have really helped me to be more productive in my day, but still enjoy and connect with the people that I love. And I absolutely love even connecting with all of you guys. I love to see your pictures and answer your messages. And I still can do that. I just don't need to be checking it all the time, and I don't need to be spending hours on there. The same can be said for extracurricular activities with kids. Now, I think that sports are wonderful. I think that the arts are so important. But I also think that having a calm family home is just as important, if not more so, than whether my kids are in extracurricular activities. So we are completely led by our kids with what they want to do. If it's really important to them, we will make it happen. However, I'm not going to put my kids into one activity just because they need something to do. We are outside all the time, in the fresh air, at the beach, at the playground, at the library. I'm certainly not worried about their artistic education or their physical education, but if they want to do something, we do it. But I do have one rule, that we do not do anything that falls on the weekend. Our weekends are so precious, and I'm happy to, you know, push through during the week, but we keep our weekends free to spend with the kids. So guys, I hope this has given you a little bit of an insight into how we simplified and minimalized our routines to make our days flow a bit better and to put the priorities back into check where they should be. If you've got any tips for what you like to do to keep them in check, please leave them down below in the comments. I absolutely love to hear from you. If you're new, we would love to have you subscribe and join our community. Here are some videos we think you might like, and I can't wait to catch you guys in the next one.